Today, we're going all 3D. Let's create a 3D camera tracker with 3D objects. We're going to take a deep dive into After Effects Beta's most updated 3D workflow and the trick to adding native effects to a 3D object in your After Effects composition. You don't want to miss this. So I'm in After Effects Beta, the 2024 version 24.3, and I'm going to show you the newest features that they incorporated, which is an improvement on their advanced 3D feature. So as you could see, I have a clip here of a car driving in this vast landscape. First, I'm going to click on my clip and my sequence, and I'm going to go to Track and Stabilize, Track Camera. I'm going to let this analyze in the background as I import my 3D files. Now I'm going to import a few of my OBJ files and maybe some GLBs as well. One thing is, if you don't want to create 3D models yourself, it's super time consuming and tedious, there's a few free resources out there. I like to use Adobe Stock's library, which has a lot of free options, and also TurboSquid has a really nice selection as well, and some free options too. I'll throw those links below. Also, if you want to get real crazy, you could generate 3D models using generative AI. I like to use this site, lumalabs.ai. It's very cool. I'll throw that link below as well. So then once my 3D camera tracker is complete, you can see that it gives me all these points throughout the space of the shot. When I import one of my OBJ files and drag it into my comp, you could see the model settings pop up, just as if you were to import a GLB file. So I'm going to bring that scale down in the object scale, and I'm going to hit OK. Now I want to make sure that my anchor point is at the bottom surface level of my object here. So when I track it, there's no space between the object and the actual ground plane. So I'm going to make sure that on each view here that my anchor point's on the bottom. So now in my 3D camera tracker, I'm going to pick a point over here somewhere. And I'm going to click new null and camera. And you can see it kind of jumps already. I'm going to go to my null. I'm going to go to my transform. And I'm going to copy my anchor point, position, and scale. Copy these parameters and paste them into my lime layer. You can see it jumps again, but I could just change the orientation of my lime a little bit. Okay, so I'm gonna adjust this quite a bit. Obviously I'm at half resolution here, but the tracking looks really, really good. And then from there, I could add a new point light and I could change the positioning of it to try to kind of be where the sun's coming from. And I could change the intensity. I'm gonna try to make it a little bit higher. I mean, the key is to kind of look where the shadows are in the shot, look where the highlights are, and try to mimic the natural light of the scene. All right, now I'm gonna show you a trick on how to add effects to 3D layers. So I'm gonna go to New Solid, and I'm gonna make it comp size. Any color will do. I'm gonna bring this underneath my lime, and then I'm gonna go to Calculations Effect, drag that onto my solid layer, then in second layer, I'm gonna select my lime, and in second layer opacity, I'm gonna bring this to 100%. And if I solo my layer, you could see the lime is there, but the only thing is the background still there. So in order to fix that, I'm gonna duplicate the calculations effect. Under blending mode on the second one, I'm gonna bring this to stencil alpha. And you could see if I hide my lime layer, this maintains all the parameters that the OBJ file does. So even if I change my point light on my 3D layer, you could see it affects the solid layer as well. This is a super easy way to add effects to your 3D layer. I could add a camera lens blur, I could add match grain effect, which I like to do when working with 3D files. And with this, most of all, I could add a drop shadow or masks, which I could use for my contact shadows. All these little techniques make it that more realistic. And obviously I could add any color correcting effects like Lumetri color and tweak the contrast and vibrance and whatnot. So there it is. Here's my final shot. I just added a few aspects to it, like overall tilt shift blur, and I added a few more fruits to it using the same process.